I'd like to acknowledge the Cammeraygal, the original caretakers of this land, who for thousands of years cared for our environment, including right behind us, Sydney Harbour. Now here at Taronga, we share that same connection. All the seals that you're about to meet are either rare, rescued or relocated. These amazing animals are Taronga's ambassadors for the wild. Now the first seal we're meeting, her name is Nala. She is a rare Australian sea lion. Here she is, please make her welcome. Now, Nala herself was actually born right here at Taronga 13 years ago. She forms part of our breeding program here at Taronga. She's already bred two of her very own pups, contributing to the species, isn't that right? That's right. Now, unfortunately for the species, there's less than 10,000 of them left in the wild. They're naturally found on the coastline of South Australia and along the southern end of Western Australia. Their numbers continue to decline. There is a lot of research going into why that's happening. But as I said, she is a very important part of our team here at Taronga. Now, did you know you've got something in common with Nala? Have a look at your hand. Now, let's have a look at the front flipper. The bone structure in your hand and her flipper are in fact the same. Now, those flippers may look awkward for getting around on land, but they're surprisingly quite fast and quite nimble. So, let's have a look as she goes for a walk. Or a run.
Oh.
See, she uses all four of those flippers, easily getting to the top there. Good job there, Nala.
Wow.
But those flippers, and a good catch, those flippers are obviously very well designed for use in the water. Now what she's doing here is called porpoising or bowing, a very quick and energy efficient way to get around our oceans. As she cruises along there, you'll notice she actually takes a quick breath of air while speeding along. Now this is also used extremely well when chasing prey or getting away from predators. Now the ocean is a pretty big place. There are different types of predators out there. Seals are obviously one of them. There is, however, one other type. Now this particular predator can actually be quite misunderstood, but is very important to a healthy ocean, and Nala's going to give you a bit of a clue as to what it looks like.
What is that, Luna?
Any ideas? A shark. One of the best looking sharks out there. Now, although Nala does do a great shark impersonation, what you're seeing is a natural behaviour that seals use to cool down. Those thick coats are great at keeping the heat in, but it's those naked and hairless flippers that let the heat out. As they're cruising along the surface of the ocean, they just hold one of those flippers up, efficiently cooling themselves down. Now, those front flippers are very, very strong. They are so strong that they can actually hold up their entire body weight. Isn't that right, Nala? There you go, showing off again, Nala. Well, that was our first part of the show. We're going to use those flippers for one more thing, and that's to say goodbye.
Bye.
We're making way for two friends of ours. Please welcome our keeper, Addie, here with Pepper.
Oh, Pepper.
Thank you, keeper Jose and Nala, and didn't they do a great start to the presentation? So this handsome boy is Pepper, and he too is a he's a sea lion like Nala, which means he has a single layer of fur, but he's a Californian sea lion, which means these seals are naturally found in the Northern Hemisphere. And Pepper was actually born in a zoo in Europe and came to us as a youngster. Now, as I said, he's 16 years of age and at the moment weighing just shy of 240 kilos. Ooh. Now, Pepper this afternoon is here to show us all the life of a seal.
This is a place where I don't feel alone.
Now, life for a seal out in the wild isn't always easy, and human impact is one of their greatest challenges. Pepper, you did a great job, and I need to get you a big bucket of fish. Didn't he do a great job, everyone?
Yeah.
And on the count of three, calling out the word whiskers. One, two, three.
Whiskers!
Good job. It's those amazing whiskers that help seals find fish in dark and murky water, hunt for food at night, and also at great depths. The whiskers are very important for the life of a seal. Now, Pepper at the moment is eating 11 kilos of fish every single day. That's two buckets full to the brim. But Pepper, what happens when that fish runs out? Very sad. We're overfishing our waters, making it harder and harder for Pepper's wild cousins to find their next meal. Now, Pepper, do you want to come on down by the edge of the pool and have a quick look? Quick look inside. You ready? Did you see anything? No. Pepper, is there something that we can do to help your wild cousins? Yes, there is. Our choices matter. The next time you go and purchase seafood, look for products with the blue and white fish tick that you see on the wharf below Pepper. The MSC fish tick, now I should tell you, it's a Marine Stewardship Council and it's an international certification of sustainability. From the point of catch all the way through to the point of sale, it's not a brand, it doesn't belong to anyone. But by purchasing seafood with that tick, Pepper, which tick? That one there, means that you're helping to support a fishery that supports fish stocks, jobs and their environment. And doing that, it also makes Pepper a very happy seal. Where's your happy face? There it is. Good job. Pepper, always a champion. But now it's our turn to say goodbye to everybody and head off home. Good job.
Bye-bye.
Please keep the applause going as we welcome... Oh, sorry, friend. As we welcome our keeper... and with her seal, Diego.
Wow. Out here with the gorgeous Diego. And Diego is another one of our California sea lions. He is a little bit younger than Pepper. Pepper being about 15 and Diego here is 10. And they happen to be best friends as well. Do you want to say hi to everyone, Diego? Well done, buddy. A part of caring for our seals means teaching them behaviors. And Diego here won't do anything he doesn't want to do. It all takes time and it takes a lot of trust. The behavior can be something quite simple, like asking Diego to open his mouth so I can do a quick health check. I see your teeth, buddy. Good job, well done. Or it can be something far more challenging and high energy, like the next behavior Diego's going to show us. He's going to do what we call a high bow. He's going to jump off of our cliff into the water and attach his bowl with his nose. We're going to do that today as part of a training session, but I need everyone's help. On the count of three, I need everyone to throw your arms up into the air and yell out, jump Diego. But he's not going to make it from where he's sitting. So Diego, do you want to head on up, buddy?
Whoa. Whoa.
All right, Diego's in position. Everyone's ready? I'll count you down. One, two, three.
Yeah.
I thought you did a really good job, but Diego's only got little ears. So let's ask him, Diego, what happened? Was that loud enough for you? He said no. That's all right, though. We've got a big audience today. So I'm sure this time we can be even louder and with a lot more energy, jump Diego on three. One, two, three.
Yeah!
Whoa! Excellent jump from Diego.